I'm going to show you how to color grade and how to create custom LUTs in 3D LUT Creator Pro. With this software, you can instantly simulate the color grading from your favorite movie and apply it to your photos or footage. But more after the intro. Hey, I'm Chris and welcome to iStalker, the place where you'll find photo and video editing tutorials and also tech reviews. If you don't want to miss anything, consider subscribing and hit the bell. Also, I'm doing a giveaway in this video because the channel reached 20,000 subscribers recently. You are so awesome, guys. Thank you so much for subscribing and watching my content. 3D LUT Creator is sponsoring this video by giving you the chance to win one pro license. So watch the entire video because I will show you some very cool things. So first, I'm going to show you how to create a custom LUT, which you can instantly apply on your photos opened in Photoshop, and also how to save the custom LUT and apply it on your footage in Premiere Pro. Then I will take a frame from Stranger Things 2, which is already color graded, and apply the same color grading to your photo. It's gonna be an exciting video. I will also tell you how you can enter this giveaway contest. So stay tuned and let's get to work. Let's start with a photo opened in Photoshop. As you can see, it has a flat look. I can switch to the 3D LUT Creator and then import the photo from Photoshop and continue my work from here. 3D LUT Creator is a very complex software. It has lots of buttons and tabs, but it's very organized, and with some practice, you'll find it very user-friendly. I cannot cover all these buttons and tabs in a single video, but if you want to learn more about the basics of the software, down in the description, you'll find a link to the 3D LUT Creator website and YouTube channel, which has already lots of useful tutorials. So I will choose the Curves tab and create a classic S-curve to increase the contrast on the photo. I can always check the before and after by pressing the backslash shortcut or by clicking here on Compare. And my screen will be divided in before on top and after at the bottom. If I want to divide them horizontally, I just right-click on Compare. Now I go to the AB tab. There is a drop-down here which allows me to select the color space model, so I'm gonna select LAB, lab, because that's my favorite one at the moment. Okay, long story short, the middle point in the grid represents the neutral colors in the image, like whites and grays or any less saturated color. And the points located at the margins of the grid are the most saturated. Now, before starting to drag any of these points, I want to increase the overall saturation on this image. There's a slider right here which allows me to do that, and I will stop somewhere around 150. I hit the backslash again for before and after, and it's already a big difference from that initial flat look. I can start to work with the grid now and shift some colors. Unlike Photoshop, where first I need to add an adjustment layer to change colors or even create some masks, 3D LUT Creator makes things so easy. Let me show you. If I want to change the color of the trees, I can move the mouse over the trees, and on the left side of the screen on the grid, the color which I want to change is highlighted with a square. So for example, if I want to add more saturation into the greens, I will grab that point and pull it into the exterior of the grid to make it more saturated. If I want to undo my last step, I just press Ctrl Z, or I can also click on this little button right here to reset the whole grid. An easier way to add more vibrance or saturation or to shift any of these colors in the image is to click on the photo and drag the color that I want to change. So click and drag to the upper left to increase the saturation of the trees. Of course, I can even go to orange color to simulate an autumn look in this photo, but in this case, let's stick with the greens because the pine trees are green even in winter season. I can even go nuts with this and select all these points on the grid by including them in a rectangle selection and shift all the trees to a blue color. But this looks like Avatar, so now I'm going back home to the green area. I want to change the sky and push the blues towards the aqua colors. So I'm going to select and drag this point to the left side, and you can see how the color of the sky is shifting on the image. Also, I place my mouse on the blue sky, and by holding down Shift and dragging the mouse downwards, I can darken the blue color. Let's also make the clouds brighter with the same procedure, holding down shift, but this time pushing the mouse upwards. And as a last step, I want to introduce some color into the neutral point as well. But what color should I choose? Well, let's analyze a bit the colors in this image. I have green, blue, and the third color should be red. This is called the triad, and I recommend you to study the color wheel because it will help you a lot when creating LUTs and color grading. You can find it on color.adobe.com, and if you select triad, you can see that in this case, it's recommended to use red, green, and blue. So, back to 3D LUT Creator, I'm gonna grab the neutral point on the grid and push it just a bit towards the red color. So I think my LUT is ready now. I can check the before and after, and you can see how big the difference is between the original image and the edited one. So here comes the step that you're waiting for, how to export this LUT into Photoshop. It's so simple. You just press on this LUT to PS. But before doing that, you need to choose File, Preferences, choose the Integration tab, and make sure to choose the right version of Photoshop that you are using. You can even choose Custom Adobe Photoshop, which lets you choose the exact location of Photoshop in your computer. So press this button, wait for a second or two, and the LUT file is loaded as an adjustment layer in Photoshop on top of the original image. From here, I can lower the opacity of the LUT if I feel this is too much for me, and I can even change the layer blending mode to soft light, for example. Now, if I want to apply this LUT to other images as well, and to be able to always find it in this list right here, I should save the LUT. For this, I'm going back to 3D LUT Creator and click on Save 3D LUT. First, save it to any folder in your computer. Let's name it LUT1 and click Save. And then copy the LUT and browse to the LUTs folder in Photoshop. On a PC, this will be in Program Files, Adobe. For me, it's Adobe Photoshop CC 2018, Presets, and 3D LUTs. Paste the file here, and you need to give permission for this, so click on Continue. Otherwise, if you will try to save it from 3D LUT Creator into this folder, you won't get this notification and your LUT will not appear in Photoshop's lookup table list. After you restarted Photoshop and opened your image, you can add a color adjustment layer above your original image and you'll see that LUT 1 is here. And you can apply it over and over again on your images in Photoshop. Now let me show you how to use 3D LUT Creator to create and import a LUT in Premiere Pro CC. I have this slow motion sequence. It's shot on a Canon G7X Mark II with the CineStyle profile, so it's really flat. I'm gonna save a screenshot from this movie, save it to a folder, and then I will drag and drop it in 3D LUT Creator. I will use again the curves to create some contrast, and then I'm gonna use the Channels tab to create the teal and orange look. So I'm gonna grab this point and bring it to the left side until I find my favorite spot. And I think that's perfect. Going to the AB tab, I increase the saturation. And then I'm gonna save the 3D LUT to my folder and name it LUT2. Now I'm gonna copy the LUT, browse to Program Files, Adobe, Adobe Premiere Pro 2018, Lumetri, LUTs, Creative, and paste the file here. After you restarted Premiere Pro and reopened your project file, go to the Lumetri Color panel, open the Creative tab, and LUT2 should be in your list. After it's loaded, you can lower the intensity if you want, and make sure that you first color correct your video before applying color grading. I have a tutorial on that if you're interested. It's in the card right now. Okay, now comes the best part of this tutorial. I have this screenshot from Stranger Things 2, and I really like the look of it, so I want to apply it on this image that I have opened in Photoshop. In 3D LUT Creator, I'm gonna click on Image from PS, and after the image is loaded, I go to File and Load Reference Image. I choose the frame from Stranger Things, and then I go to Edit, Auto Match Colors to Reference. There are a couple of sliders that you can tweak here to obtain different results in color hue, and when you're satisfied with your result, click OK And here is the before and after. This is amazing. You can see how the grid adapted to the new look. I'm gonna hit LUT to PS and the LUT is applied in Photoshop as well. You can also use this LUT in Premiere Pro. So guys, I think this software is amazing. You can go to 3dlutcreator.com and check out the prices and what's included in every version of the software. The version that I have is the Pro version, so it includes all the fancy stuff and many other features that I couldn't include in this tutorial because it will take me hours to show you everything that this software can do. But like I said in the beginning of this video, the 3D LUT Creator team is giving away one Pro license that you can win here on my channel. There are a few things you need to do to enter this contest. Subscribe to the channel and push the bell. Hit the like on this video and share it to Facebook or Twitter. Leave a comment down below and tell me if you tried to color grade your photos until now and what software did you use for that. The 3D LUT Creator Pro license will go to a random commenter on this video here on YouTube, so make sure you comment. The winner will be announced on November 20 on my Instagram and Twitter, so make sure you follow me there as well. That's it. Feel free to watch some other videos on the screen. I'm Chris. Thank you so much for spending the time with me and see you soon.